Welcome to Woggle Guides. In this guide, we're going to take a look at how to use and manage labels in Gmail on the Apple iPhone. Let's get straight into it. Remember, you can click on the sections below to jump straight to your particular area of interest. So the first thing we'll look at is an area that can confuse a lot of people. What are labels? Many email tools use folders to help sort emails. Gmail uses labels to do this, and they function almost exactly in the same way as folders, with one significant difference. Whilst in other email tools, such as Outlook, emails can only be moved and stored in a single folder, in Gmail, emails can be assigned to multiple labels. So, you know that email you get every week from your Uncle Frank? In other email tools, you have to decide whether to store that email in the funny, family, or weird folder. But in Gmail, you have the option to store it in all three labels. Let's start by looking at how we can assign a label whilst in an email. Firstly, let's go into an email. And to assign a label, we click on the three dots on the top right bar of the email to see some more options. From the options list shown, we choose Change Labels. And remember, you can assign to multiple labels by tapping the label name. And to confirm the label selection, click on the tick on the right of the top bar. And Gmail confirms that three labels have been added to the email. So let's now move to the inbox and we'll look at how to assign labels to multiple emails. To choose multiple labels, we long press on the first email we want to assign to a label. Once the tick appears on the left hand side, we can then go on to choose multiple emails just by clicking on them. Once we've selected a few emails, to assign a label to them, we click on the three dots on the right on the top bar. And from the options shown, we choose Change Labels. Multiple labels can then be selected for all the emails chosen. And to confirm the selection, choose the tick on the right of the top bar. And Gmail confirms that three labels have been added to those emails. Let's look now at how we create a new label as part of assigning an email to a label. We'll go into an email to do that, but you can follow the exact same process from the inbox for multiple labels. Once in the email, we click on the three dots on the top right bar of the email to see some more options. From the options list shown, to create a label, choose Move To. Remember, you can also use the Move To option to assign an email directly to a single label. So, to create a new label, click the plus sign on the right of the top bar. Gmail will then ask you to create a label name. Let's do that now. And to confirm it, we choose Done on the right of the top bar. Gmail then confirms that the email has been assigned to the new label that has been created. Before we finish on labels, let's take a quick look at how you can edit and delete labels. To do that, let's go into the navigation menu by clicking on the hamburger icon in the top left. We then scroll down to the settings options at the bottom of that menu. And let's click into it. To go deeper into settings, choose the Google user ID. Next, we scroll down to the label settings option on that menu. And once we click into that, we see a list of all existing labels. To edit or delete any label, simply click into it. To edit it, click on the label name and you can amend the original name. Once updated, click Done in the top bar on the right to confirm that change. To delete that label, choose the red Delete Label Name option. Gmail will ask you to confirm this choice. To do that, we click Delete once more to confirm, and the label name disappears from our list. I do hope you found this Woggle guide useful. If you have, please subscribe so that other users can find it too. And if you have any questions on using the Gmail app on your iPhone, please share in the comments section down below. Look after yourself until next time.